A new report's revealed that Saudi Arabia has been killing refugees that are trying to seek asylum in their country. And some survivors are saying that the Saudi military is walking right up to people, shooting them dead right on the border. Now, here's the problem. United States, as usual, because it's Saudi Arabia, we don't care. Okay, they're buying our jets for, you know, 80 gazillion dollars a piece, whatever it is. They're coming to the United States. We're training their pilots right here down the road from where we live. We're, you know, buying their oil. We are prisoners to Saudi Arabia and this insane prince. I mean, is there any other way to describe this guy other than insane? And this is being driven, promise you, by him.
Yeah, we've got a new report from Human Rights Watch. Ethiopians coming from Africa, crossing through Yemen. I mean, they're escaping, you know, horrendous conditions back home. They make it to the border in Saudi Arabia. And if they survive the bombing, because we've got reports from these refugees that Saudi Arabia is sending missiles at them. They're just bombing the hell out of them. The ones who survive that are then met with these Saudi border guards who, in some instances, according to these reports, will go, which limb do you want me to shoot you in?
Before I kill you.
Yes.
In other words, they're shown up. They make it past all of that. And then they say,
where would you like to be shot?
You want to shoot you in the leg? We want to shoot you in the arm before we kill you.
And this is men, women, and children that are being slaughtered. And the ones who are not slaughtered, many of them end up in these internment camps that Saudi Arabia has. They're being tortured. They're being raped. They're being put into forced labor. This is, if you replace the word Saudi Arabia with Russia, if you replace it with North Korea or Iran, U.S. troops would already be there banging on their door saying, we're getting rid of you. But because it's our good friends in Saudi Arabia, we look the other way and they commit these gross
abuses. And you know who their best friend is? The weapons industry.
Yep.
The weapons industry is making an absolute killing from Saudi Arabia buying weapons to go kill folks in Yemen. But the stories are horrendous. Girls, teenage girls making across the border are being raped, along with being, before they're shot through the arm or shot through the leg, they're first raped, then they're basically tortured, and then the border guards kill them. One thing, what was the story about if they're injured, if they can't walk, if they've got some kind of injury, they send them out into a field and drop mortars on them?
Yeah.
Did I get that story right?
Yeah, that is one thing that Human Rights Watch talked about in this report. And it's difficult to talk about this. And I hope people understand that this is such a massive story. This is an absolute abuse of human rights. The entire world should be condemning
Saudi
Arabia.
Tell me where it's being reported. Did you see this on the nightly news?
No. Human Rights Watch is the only place I've seen it.
You see it in New York Times?
No.
No. You don't see it on Fox, MSNBC, CNN. Why? Same reason. And we talk about this all the time. When you see a Raytheon ad, a Boeing ad on CNN or MSNBC or any of the networks, Fox, why is that ad there? It's not that, hey, Raytheon, man, they make missiles. Maybe I'm going to need missiles someday. It is because they're buying access.
Yeah.
They're buying influence with the network, okay? And so if they want to kill a story, they'll do it. As a matter of fact, and as you look at this story, you understand that this is a prince that's reneged on every promise he's ever made to us. Remember, he hustled Biden.
Oh,
he said, Biden, you do this for me, sell me more jets, and I'm not gonna raise the price of oil. And what was it, 2 months later, gets the jets and raises the price of oil. How many times do we have to go through that? How many times do we have to see him, this prince, moving closer and closer to China and Russia in building this new alliance while we're selling him our best weapons? How long do we have to wait till we say this is not good for the American public?
You know, and even before this story came out, we have talked again for 20 years about the gross human rights abuses of Saudi Arabia. I mean, killing people for tweets. You know, a record number of people killed for that, killing them for disagreeing, saying, hey, I'm not happy with what my government's doing. Okay, you're dead now.
About 82, 8500, we don't know, somewhere in that range, beheaded every year in a public square.
Yeah.
And it's not because they stole anything. It's not because they robbed anybody. It's because they said something that this idiot prince didn't like, who now is our best friend. He's now best friends with the weapons industry, I guess, so he's best friends with us. You know, and then how, again, we continue to overlook the murder of 3,000 Americans on American soil, and we know Saudi Arabia was responsible for it. We know that this administration right now won't even release the 9/11 investigation because it's fraught with information that says, yeah, this was done by Saudi Arabia. I just don't know how long it takes, man. I don't know how long it takes. And so do we support the administration because, hell, this is their decision, and by God, they're Democrat or they're Republican, and we have to support them in that? Is that what we've become, really?
It feels like it. And I will tell you, there's only one candidate I've seen that's ever talked about the dangers of Saudi Arabia, and that, of course, was Bernie Sanders in 2020.
Absolutely.